Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Me and brother Rahman off to do Ziyarah of Makkah Sharif. Ziyarahs include, I think it's Jannat al-Mana, Mina, Arafat, Muzdalifa, other places as well. So inshallah, stay in tune guys. We shall be doing that. Brother Rahman, you excited?
Aye, pretty much. Nah, yeah, I am.
Sparky, but look at me. Sparky,
look. I am, inshallah, yeah. Hopefully, we see inshallah. Good ziyarats.
What ziyarats are you looking forward to?
I don't know. Eh? I've not been told yet. Which ziyarats and everything, but
inshallah. This is the Amir of the group.
It's quite noisy.
You might not be able to hear me, but Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you know, we're at the place where the two best companions, RasoolAllah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him, spent three whole nights. You know, Allah knows what kind of love, you know, was on this. Have a look at this, SubhanAllah. That is the Asghari Thor. People are actually climbing that at the moment. SubhanAllah, people are actually climbing that. Allahu Akbar. Might not be able to see it properly, but SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah, what love did Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq have for Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? It's absolutely amazing, seriously. It's just, I wish I had time to go, but inshallah when I go next to Umrah, I'm definitely going for it, inshallah. But just to think that the personality Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him, the best of people after all the Prophets, and the best of creation, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, spent three whole nights in there. SubhanAllah, what would be the maqam of the Allahu Akbar? SubhanAllah, amazing. SubhanAllah. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barak wa sallim. Salatu wa salamu alayki ya Rasulullah wa ala alika wa sahabiki ya Habibullah. Absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. This is the plains of Arafat. This is Jubilee. I got sidetracked there a bit. So inshallah, we'll go up and show you in there. So this is it, man. This is where it's all gonna go down. This is a vital part of Hajj. This is Hajj basically. You know, this is gonna be the day. This will be Arafat day from start to finish. From Zuhur to Maghrib, this is where you will do Dua. Well, all of it's plains of Arafat, but this is the majority part of it. Inshallah. So. Hamara bhai ja raha hai upar. Kaise feel ho rahe hai bhai? MashaAllah. Brother, this is Sheikh Ahsan here. How you doing, brother?
I'm okay.
You ready to go up Jabal Rahmat?
I'm just following the brother here, Sheikh Irfan and...
Me Sheikh? No Sheikh. This is where everybody wants to be on the day of Arafat. Well, it's not that safe to be honest. Alhamdulillah. You made it. You go down now? Sheikh Saab, kaise feel kar rahe ho?
Yellow marks.
Kaise yaar, kafi garmi lag rahi hai.
Sheikh Saab ke Mulana Saab, kaise feel kar rahe ho? This is our dear brother, mashallah.
If you're not inside the boundaries of Boston,
smile, brother, smile. It's our Sheikh Saab. Mashallah. If you want any duas, email them sheikh.google.com.
Sheikh.google.com. I bet that's already taken.
I know. So this is the plains of Arafat.
and wanna know about it. My answer will be, it's everything about Allah, the pure love to our souls, the creator of you and me, the heavens and the whole universe, the one that made us whole and free, the guardian of his true believers. So when
the just wanted to show you guys this scene. This is after Zohar. Imagine this, but you know, but 2 or 3 times more busier at Isha time. This is after Zohar, people coming after Namaz. Just give me 2 seconds, I'll show you guys. From our room, by the way, I think this is the previous video anyway that's been made about that, but alhamdulillah, you know, we could not fault this hotel for the location. SubhanAllah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Just read Zohar Namaz, so I thought I'd get my money exchanged. Just a quick tip about the money exchange, the best rate that I found in the UK was 5.7. That was very, very hard rate I found from Marks and Spencer's. Other rates I found were 5.6, 5.2, 5.4, 5, you know, down to 5.0. I think actually 5.2 was the lowest. Just got my money exchanged. The exchange rate at the moment is 5.9, so amazing rate compared to the UK. So my tip would be exchange about £50 worth of riyals before you come, just in case there's any emergencies, you need to buy a drink or food or something like that. And over here you can exchange it at 5.90. But obviously when you guys see this, the rates obviously will fluctuate up or down, but that's the rate at the moment anyway. So yeah, just exchange a little bit and then, but alhamdulillah, it's been an amazing experience so far. You know, it's getting busier and busier and busier and busier. As you can see, that's people just coming out of Salah there. You know, it's getting so packed. You know, the key is to go for one namaz, say for example Asr, stay there till Isha. Another tip that I'll give you guys is do not get out of the masjid from Maghrib till Isha, because you will get stuck, you will get pushed, you may even get injured by a wheelchair. So I would just advise all brothers and sisters to stay at the Masjid al-Haram between Maghrib and Isha especially. Don't go anywhere from Maghrib to Isha because it's jam-packed. You know, it's very, very packed. But alhamdulillah, you know, you see a lot of people. Alhamdulillah, I met a converted brother, Brother Bilal from the UK, converted 12 years ago. This is his first Hajj. I met another Nigerian brother converted to Islam from Christianity 5 years ago. MashaAllah, he was buzzing. He was so high. You could, seriously, we were sitting next to him and he was bouncing on the sofa. He was saying, you know, that he's so buzzed, that, you know, the feeling that he gets so much peace, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illa Allah.
Sawu, aqimu sufufakum wa atadilu. أتم الصف الأول.
سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظمت. مشانك سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ربي. As I travel through the earth I can't help but notice the symphony I hear all around, from the smallest grain of sand to the faraway planets, to a flower putting roots in the ground, every bird in the sky, every rock and every raindrop sings as it falls from the clouds, every ant, every plant, every breeze and all the seas. They all sing سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ربي. سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ندعوك ونرجو غفرانك ربي. سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك سبحانك ربي سبحانك سبحانك ما أعظم شانك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. Rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Just read Isha namaz, so I forgot there. Jam-packed again. One thing I will say to you guys that do not, whatever happens, if you come for Hajj especially, do not let the rush put you off. You will get pushed. People may say stuff to you. You know, you will get mucked around quite a lot. So whatever you do, don't let that discourage you. Don't let that put you off of coming here and enjoying the atmosphere. Look, it is buzzing. It's very, very buzzing, but don't let that put you off your ibadah. Always remember, Allah says in the Quran, in one of the ayats I read today actually, that make your pilgrimage as it's a duty upon mankind going to Allah. So don't let, you know, people come in the way of your duty to Allah. You know, embrace the change in embrace the change in atmosphere, embrace the change in society, in culture. Embrace the change, SubhanAllah, it's amazing. Different cultures, different societies all come together to worship one Allah. You will not see this anywhere, SubhanAllah. I was going to say, now make sure you take some good walking shoes. Because walking in flip-flops, you know, all the time is not a good idea. It may hurt the feet closer to Hajj. So I've invested in these walking shoes. So you can see there, I just zoom up. It's got a good grip. I think they were about £15, I think. Got them from Aldi. So even have a look at, you know, Aldi, Lidl, Tesco's, Asda, or whatever. You know, the mountain climbing shops, etc. So you invest in a good pair, and always carry a string bag. String bag with you is essential to put your, you know, items in. SubhanAllah, it's amazing. It's getting busier and busier and busier. Closer to Hajj. This is the building. That's the new hotel that they've made. So that one's made, and that one's getting made. But SubhanAllah, it's amazing. You can see there, you know, I'll zoom up and crowds and crowds of people. You know, it's a bit fuzzy, but the crowds and crowds of people coming together to worship Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's amazing. Me and brother Razwan. Razwan, brother, say salam to the peeps.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So me and brother Razwan are going to find some money exchange. It's approximately 10 o'clock, inshallah. So we're going to go and get that money exchanged. Just wanted to make this quick video just to say that wherever you are at Hajj time, there's always a medical clinic available for British Hujjaj. And this is it. So any guys who wants to go there, this is it right here. So always look out for the British Hujjaj, British clinic for them. Still about four days to go till Hajj time. So obviously they'll be in Mina, in the tents. But even in Makkah before Hajj, they're available for you guys. So any problems, any kind of situations you have, sore throat, sore head, migraines, etc., they're always there to help. Every year a team of doctors come to Makkah, to Hajj, for the British Hujjaj. So if you guys are British Hujjaj, inshallah, 2014, then keep that in mind, inshallah. So yeah, something to look out for. It's always buzzing. Always buzzing here. MashaAllah. One of the things about Makkah is, especially Medina as well, you'll get street sellers everywhere, especially after Zohar. It's always worth a look. It's always some kind of bargain there as well. Allah.